Brace yourself, taxpayers, CalPERS is about to bury you deeper in debt. The nation's largest pension system is expected to adopt a funding plan this week that anticipates shortfalls during the next decade and then banks on exceptional investment returns over the following half century to make up the difference. It's an absurd strategy designed to placate labor unions, who want more public money available now for raises, and local government officials who are struggling to make annual installment payments on past debt, CalPERS has rung up. And it highlights why the California Supreme Court, which is currently considering a key case on pension rights, and state lawmakers must do more to rein in public employee retirement costs. We can't afford the current system. That doesn't mean that traditional pensions should be eliminated. It means future benefit accruals should be reduced to affordable levels that don't continue saddling current and future generations with debt. The California Public Employees Retirement System currently has a $153 billion unfunded liability, with only 68% of the assets it should have, largely because of similar, past hubris about investment returns. The action this week will affect pensions for state workers, and hence all California taxpayers. In the Bay Area, it affects pensions for employees of Santa Clara County and most cities except San Jose and San Francisco. Specifically, the CalPERS board will reallocate its portfolio and make a critical forecast of the return on those investments. The higher the expected return, the lower the contributions required from employers and employees. But if the prediction doesn't pan out, taxpayers must cover the shortfall. CalPERS staff predicts the investment mix it's recommending will earn 7% annual returns. That just happens to match the earnings forecast that CalPERS is already phasing in. Thus, the staff suggests the rate should not be lowered, and contributions should not be further increased. But that 7% forecast is problematic. Ted Eliopoulos, CalPERS Chief Investment Officer, estimates CalPERS will only earn 6.1% annually over the next 10 years. To reach 7%, the system's actuaries blended the 10-year estimate with a projection for the subsequent 50 years of 8.3% annual returns. That's right, CalPERS, like many retirement systems, makes decisions about funding pensions today based on estimates of what market returns will be for the next six decades. To do that, CalPERS assumes the future economy will eventually mirror the past. But the future economy will be a lot different than the past, says Bob Stein, a retired Ernst & Young managing partner and chairman of the National Society of Actuaries Blue Ribbon Panel on Public Pension Funding. It requires a belief that equity returns are going to jump back up to the 8% level or even higher in the out years here. I don't think anybody expects that. CalPERS portfolio includes stocks, bonds, and real estate. Eliopoulos acknowledges the spread between CalPERS 6.1% annual forecast for the first decade and the annual 8.3% predicted for the following 50 years is as wide as we've seen. Asked whether he thinks CalPERS portfolio can earn an average 8.3% annual earnings over a half century, Eliopoulos told me, "I don't have a crystal ball.